Hello. In this WAGO tutorial, we will show you how to read and write an entire KBus node in Modbus using function code 23. For this, we have the following setup. A PFC200 that will become our Modbus master and connected to the same network we have the Modbus coupler 75362, which will then become our Modbus slave. Attached to the coupler is an 8-channel digital input module, then an 8-channel digital output module, a 2-channel analog input module, a 2-channel digital output module, and to demonstrate that complex modules are also possible, a serial RS232485 interface. We start in CODESYS 3.5 with a new project. The connection to the PFC200 has already been established. Since we have Modbus TCP connections here, we first create an Ethernet interface. And set up the network interface. We then connect the Modbus master to the Ethernet interface. At this point, it is advisable to tick the box for auto-reconnect so that the master automatically reconnects to the slave in case of a connection interruption. The slave is then connected to the master and we enter the slave IP address. In the Modbus TCP slave, we switch to Modbus slave channels. This is where the Modbus channels are created. There are different approaches as to how many and which channels are created. There is no right or wrong here, as each method has its advantages and disadvantages depending on the application. In the Modbus Basics tutorial, Modbus TCP in CODESYS 3.5, PFC as master and fieldbus coupler as slave, we showed the possibility of creating a separate Modbus channel for each module. For small systems, this is an easy and clear method, but with each additional channel, the bus load increases, which can lead to performance problems in larger systems. Moreover, in CODESYS 3.5, the number of channels is limited to a maximum of 10. It can therefore be useful to consolidate channels. For example, you could group all digital inputs into one channel with function code 2, all digital outputs with function code 15, all analog inputs with function code 3, and all analog outputs with function code 16. The complex module, the serial interface, could then be captured with function code 23, and all inputs and outputs would be recorded in 5 channels. Alternatively, you could group all inputs with function code 3 and all outputs with function code 16. The serial interfaces would then remain at function code 23. This would almost halve the number of bus queries and create a significantly more performant system. But why not read and write the entire node with all connected modules in a single channel? And this is exactly the method we want to explain in detail here. In CODESYS 3.5, there is the function code 23. Read-write multiple registers for this purpose. This packs all values into an input array and an output array and transfers them with a single Modbus query. However, this poses the challenge of finding the correct position in the array to assign variables to the corresponding Modbus addresses. WAGO provides a very nice overview in the web-based management of the Modbus coupler for this purpose. So, we switch to the WBM of the Modbus coupler and find the fieldbus menu Modbus mapping. If we expand the Modbus register item here, all modules are listed in the order they are plugged in. This column lists the input addresses that are the Modbus word addresses. We also see here that the addresses of the digital inputs are always appended after the other modules, regardless of their position. The next column lists the addresses of the outputs. In CODESYS, we add a new channel in the Modbus slave with add channel. We give it a name and select function code 23, read-write multiple registers. For cycle time, we could now reduce the time since we only have one channel that is queried. 10 milliseconds is a popular value here. However, the bus task must also run correspondingly fast. If, as in this case, we let it run in the main task, we need to adjust the value accordingly. So, our Modbus connection runs as fast as the KBus. Now we enter the start address of the read register. In our case, it is 0. The length is 15 since the first analog input is at 0 and the last digital input is at 14.7. 0 to 14 are 15 words. We also set up the write register in the same way. In our example setup here, read registers and write registers are coincidentally the same length and symmetrical. However, in a real system, this is usually not the case, and you would assign the lengths differently based on the WBM listing. This transfers all inputs and outputs in an array with Modbus, and we now have to map variables to the individual array positions. Under Modbus slave I/O mapping, the input array with a length of 0 to 14 and the output array with a length of 15 words are listed. If we expand the variable tree, all 15 words of the array are displayed. Assigning which word belongs to which module is now quite simple. If we open the list of Modbus registers from the WBM of the coupler again, the word addresses listed here correspond one-to-one to the channel numbering. Word 0 and word 1 are the two analog inputs, which are usually captured with one word variable each. The digital inputs are located in word 14 on bits 0 to 7, so we would assign a variable to each bit here. We also assign variables for the analog and digital outputs. The input of the serial interface is in words 2 to 13, thus having a length of 12 words. To read these, you could declare an array of words in the program. And call this in the I/O mapping on Modbus channel 2. Now, however, only the first word is in our array, so we need to assign the individual Modbus words to the array positions. For this, we simply specify the corresponding array position in square brackets, copy the entry into the other words, and specify the array positions. We do the same for the output array of the serial interface. Now we can read and write all inputs and outputs on the Modbus coupler in our application. And that concludes the tutorial on how to transfer an entire Modbus node using function code 23. Please leave us a thumbs up if you found the video helpful, subscribe to the channel, and contact the WAGO Support Center if you have any questions.